We will now hear the statement of the Prime Minister of Israel, Mr. Benjamin Netanyahu.
Prime Minister Mitsotakis, a good friend Kyriakos, welcome to you and your ministers on behalf of the Israeli government and the people of Israel. This is the first G2G, perhaps in the world, I don't know, in the Corona period, or one of them. I think this reflects two things. It reflects the fact that we have been both quite successful in battling the Corona epidemic, and it also reflects the tremendous friendship that is building between Israel and Greece. Recently, we celebrated 30 years of upgrading the relationship to full diplomatic relations. This was done by your late father, who was also the Prime Minister of Greece. So there is a closing of a circle and the beginning of a continuing a direction of close ties. These ties are very natural between Greece and Israel. First, because there is a kinship, an ancient kinship between us. Jerusalem and Athens, Athens and Jerusalem are the two foundations of Western civilization. We're very proud to be the bearers of that legacy, and we're very proud to be the joint bearers of that legacy. Second, there was an anomaly that for some reason our two modern democracies at the edge of the Mediterranean and the Eastern Mediterranean did not have these close and natural contacts. And so once we established them, everything started to flow, and it's flowing in the right direction. We have common interests, we face common challenges, we have extraordinary common opportunities. The challenges in the world and in our region are obvious, everything from firefighting, Greek pilots. I always mention this, Greek pilots, a Greek pilot turned, extinguished the fires in Haifa a few years ago. We have complementary emergency services. We cooperate there, and this, of course, extends to a much larger goal of ensuring security and stability and prosperity in our region. And prosperity can only be ensured if we can ensure security and stability. There is widespread defense cooperation, both in training, now in defense projects and various possibilities that we believe we can cooperate in to assure that stability and that security in our region. This extends to cybersecurity and the joint efforts that we're making in this regard. It extends to intelligence sharing, to every field that enables our two democracies and our two countries that seek peace and stability to assure peace and stability in our region. The opportunities are vast. They include physical resources and the products of the mind. The physical resource, the obvious physical resource, is gas. We have findings of gas, substantial findings of gas offshore. Cyprus has that too. And our most important project, which we discussed at length and will continue to discuss over lunch, is the laying of the EastMed pipeline that will connect the gas fields of Israel and Cyprus through Greece, through Cyprus to Greece, to Europe. This would be the longest underwater pipeline in the world. We're committed to it. We discussed about how to advance it. On the products of the mind, we talked about the vast potential that our cooperation can do to enhance the capacity for innovation in the high-tech industries in both our countries. Greece has an abundant supply of very talented engineers and scientists, and Israel is obviously in that place too, and we seek, our high-tech industries seek to expand their abilities, and there's no better place to do it in Greece. That's already happening in Cyprus. We think with the reforms that you are bringing, Prime Minister, to Greece, and the fact that the markets are taking note, everybody's taking note. Well, I can assure you Israel too is taking note, and I think the Israeli high-tech industry is eager to hear your vision of the future this afternoon. So you know that you have our, not only our blessings, but our confidence in the direction in which you're putting Greece economically and in the joint cooperation between us in this area as well. It will serve both our economies and both our peoples. The final area that I'm going to mention today, we have other areas, obviously, cooperation, like marine agriculture, which I think is the way to feed the world's population in the future with proteins. We have many, many fields of potential cooperation, but the one that I'll talk about is a simple one. It's called tourism. We had an incredible 1.2 million Israeli tourists in Greece last year. 1.2 million Israeli tourists. When I first met one of your predecessors, the number was, I think, around 50,000. So it's grown. I promised him that it would get up to 400,000. It's tripled since. This is an expression also of the sympathy and the high regard in which Israelis hold Greece. Obviously, we've had a problem. We were expecting to be able to increase that number easily, but Corona is getting in our way. We are looking now at the possibility of targeting the opening of tourism, in which case Greece and Cyprus will be the first points of destination. And we would like to set August 1st as a target date. This is contingent on what happens in terms of the numbers of the epidemic, whether we keep it under control. But if we are satisfied with the numbers, then what we would like to do is target August 1st as the opening, the date of the opening of the skies. אנחנו מדברים פה על יעד, תאריך יעד של ראשון באוגוסט לפתיחת השמיים, ליעדים קודם כל של יוון וקפריסין. אנחנו, זה תלוי במה יקרה במגפה, מה יקרה עם הקורונה, אבל אם המספרים יאפשרו זאת, זהו תאריך היעד לפתיחת השמיים, זו בשורה חשובה מאוד לישראל, אני מאמין גם ליוון. So that is our plan. Part of it. We have many, many other things that we're considering, but I think this reflects the fact that you're here with your ministers, with the ministers of the Israeli government, talking about these various areas of cooperation, I think tells us that Greece and Israel have a tremendous past, but an even greater future together. Welcome. Welcome, friend.
Thank you.
And a shaking of hands in the air.
Distant shaking of hands.
Indeed.
Corona. Type.
Yes, indeed.
Thank you so much, Prime Minister. And we'll continue with the statement of the Prime Minister of the Hellenic Republic, Mr. Kyriakos Mitsotakis.
Well, first of all, let me start by expressing my gratitude to Prime Minister Netanyahu for the very warm welcome and hospitality he has extended to my entire delegation. And as I prepared for this trip and I was going through my archives, I found a statement made by my late father, Konstantin Mitsotakis, back in 1990, when he said at the time that the friendship between Greece and Israel is and should continue to be a fundamental pillar of Greek foreign policy. That statement was made at a time when this relationship was not so obvious as it is today. But I still feel that these remarks have never felt more prescient than they do today. And I have thought a lot about the meaning of those words in the past few weeks. We had a chance to virtually commemorate the 30th anniversary of the establishment of our diplomatic relations between our two countries on May 21st, and I am here today on the first post-COVID phase one, I should say, foreign trip that I make with eight of my ministers to talk to the new Israeli government about ways that we can mutually strengthen but also broaden our strategic partnership through closer cooperation in a number of key areas. I would like to point out that this is a very strong strategic partnership. It's solid. It stands on its own merit. It's not determined by other actors. But it is a relationship that can grow and strengthen still further. We've had a chance with the Prime Minister to talk about COVID-19. And we participate, jointly participate, in a group of countries from around the globe, which is called Smart COVID-19 Management, where we have shared valuable lessons and experiences on how to tackle this unique and devastating problem. I think we've both done a pretty good job in addressing the first wave of the pandemic. However, we know that after successfully overcoming the first phase, it would be far from smart management if we were to relax our guard today. And it's important to constantly send the message that we must stay vigilant, we must prepare for a possible second wave, and hopefully technology and breakthroughs in medical science will help us in this front. And we've had a chance to discuss also very interesting work that is done by scientists here in Israel on this front. At the same time, we fully recognize that we need to restart our economies and return to a new normal. Both our countries are leading tourist destinations. For us, it is important to open Greece to foreign tourists, but we will place their safety and their health as our number one priority. So as of July 1st, we will be accepting direct flights into all our main tourism destinations. And hopefully, if things go according to plan, as of August 1st, Israeli tourists will be able to travel to Greece, and we're looking forward to welcoming them. Hopefully, we can extend the season into October, why not November, to make up for some of the lost ground. What I do want to tell you is that we have worked very, very hard to ensure the safety of our guests. We have very strict health protocols. We have strengthened our medical facilities in all tourist resorts. We've thought hard about how we can open up our tourism industry to foreign travelers, but we will do it, again, by placing their safety, their health, as our number one priority. But we've also spoken about other aspects of our relationship. We will be signing protocols regarding agriculture, energy, tourism, cyber. I place particular emphasis on our cooperation when it comes to cybersecurity. I'll be meeting with a group of Israeli investors who are either active in Greece or interested in investing in Greece. There are significant opportunities for investments in Greece during this period. We have a stable, pro-reform oriented government with an absolute majority in power that has placed attracting foreign investors as our number one priority. And when I look, for example, at what is happening in your tech space and in our tech space, the synergies, Prime Minister, are more than obvious. You're looking for highly qualified engineers. We have an abundance of highly qualified engineers in our country. We are 1.5 hour away, same time zone. We offer you an entry into the EU market. We both have huge diasporas. We try to encourage our people to come back either to Israel or to Greece. We have so many talented engineers who are abroad who would like to come back to Greece, and why not work also for Israeli companies that set up a presence in our country. So in that space, in particular, I see tremendous opportunities. But of course, there are also opportunities in other sectors. We've spoken a lot about how we can strengthen our defense cooperation, not just operationally, but also in terms of defense infrastructure. Our Minister of Defense is going to be having very interesting meetings with his counterpart. There's much more we can do in terms of complementarity between our defense industries. And of course, you pointed out the tremendous importance of our trilateral relationship, Israel, Greece, Cyprus. This is a format that, with the addition of the United States in the 3+1 format, has a vision of a peaceful Eastern Mediterranean. But of course, it was in this context that the vision for the East Med pipeline was born. We're very, very happy to have you in Athens on January 2nd, when we actually signed the pipeline, and looking forward to also bringing Italy on board and starting in earnest to work on this emblematic project, which is a project of great interest for Europe as a whole, because we're looking for alternative sources of natural gas, and we're looking to exploit whatever gas is found in the Eastern Mediterranean. Of course, we also had a chance to talk about the broader region. I set out what I consider our view to be regarding Turkey's aggressive behavior in the Eastern Mediterranean. We consider this activity to be a threat to regional peace and stability, raised with the Prime Minister recent incidents of illegal and provocative Turkish behavior at our sea, air, and land borders, and of course spoke a lot about the destabilizing effect that Turkey has played vis-a-vis its relationship with Libya and what we consider to be a completely null and void agreement regarding the delimitation of maritime zones between those two countries. We will always pursue peace, having at the foundation the respect for international law and the United Nations Convention for the Law of the Seas. These are the main principles that we applied when we signed a delimitation agreement with Italy a few days ago, and it's exactly on these premises that we want to build a framework for broader regional cooperation. So I think, as the Prime Minister said, we are at the turning point where we can take stock of what happened over the past 30 years, but I'm so confident that this is a relationship that can deliver so much more to the benefit of both our people, both on the strategic geopolitical side, on the economic side, on the cultural side. We always feel so much at home when we come to Israel, and I'm sure the same, I know, I'm not sure the same applies to Israelis visiting Greece, and this is a relationship that goes back for thousands of years, and it can only grow stronger and have a brighter future. So again, Prime Minister, thank you so much for the warm welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Prime Minister, and I would kindly ask both of you to remain on the stage for the signing ceremony of the